Today's the Happy Wednesday the 22nd. It is only a few days before Christmas, and well, soon Santa might be taking a trip to your house and might be filling your stockings. So last year I made the guinea pig stockings. They were really tiny and the stitching was coming loose. So this year I thought we would try it again and turn it into a Pigmas video. So for me personally, I got these stockings at the dollar store. I got two because I have two pigs. If you do not wish to purchase them, you can always sew them. For that, you'll need fabric, cut out a pattern, and sew it along. I will do like a small one just to show for those of you who want to do it. But if you don't want to do it, then you can buy one, and today we're going to focus on decorating, and I will, of course, do brief sewing. Don't eat my scarf. Yeah, I'm wearing the same outfit as I did my last video, because I filmed these on the same day. I filmed the intros on the same day, but the actual videos were filmed on two different days. But the intros were on the same day, because, you know, multitasking is a thing I like to do over here. Anyway, so we're going to go back to my... Actually, no, I think I might sit here for the sewing process, but all the other processes will be mainly shown at my craft area, and some of it will be shown in a different part of the house because we have to use a few other supplies. So, let's head back to the craft area. Okay, so now that we're at the table, we're going to start by sketching out a stocking shape onto a piece of paper. So just kind of sketch out the shape of a stocking. I'm not the best sketcher at drawing stockings, but I'm a reasonable sewer, so. Yeah, that's kind of the idea, and then I'm just going to create a little piece for the... Now, you can sew this using a sewing machine, but I'm going to sew it using my hands. I'm going to hand stitch it, but first I need to cut the pattern out. Once the pattern is cut out, you're going to take your fabric. I've chosen this very dark fabric, mainly because this was the first fabric I saw. So you're going to kind of lie down. I bet it's going to pick up all of my paint messes, but that's okay. So, you want to create a corner kind of thing. Pardon me, it's just kind of falling. Let me situate my life really quick. Okay, and we're good. Ish. It's taking up a lot of space here. Okay. So, then along the edge of it, see where it's kind of smoothish, you are going to place the top, or you can place it like this. Either one works. And then I'm going to take a white pencil crayon. You can also use chalk. Both work. Now, this is only if you're doing it on dark fabric. Will the whole white pencil crayon idea kind of work? If you're doing it on a much lighter color, or even a pattern, it will be extremely difficult to see your pattern. So we're going to take a moment and kind of trace around it, and you'll see now we have the somewhat stocking-like shape. Okay? So now you're going to cut that out, keeping the two things attached. You can also use pins if you want. You can also use the pins, or, you know, yeah. So I'm going to cut this out. Then once you've got it cut out and pinned, pinning it is optional. I personally did it so that the pieces aren't separating. Then you can come in with your needle. However, if you don't wish to sew, or don't know how to sew, or don't have the supplies to sew, you could always use something like fabric glue or hot glue. Sewing might be a little more durable, and you can sew by hand or by a machine. I'm going to sew by hand though. So I'm going to grab a needle, and fill it with a thread. Now, normally I would say do a coordinating thread, like, you know, for me, my coordinating thread would be black or gray or something like that. But, like, that or... These would all be good candidates for coordinating thread with this particular fabric. But since I want you all to be able to have an idea of where the sewing is, I'm going to go with a different color. So I'm going to go with yellow, because yellow will be bright and you should be able to see it. So I'm going to thread my needle, and then I'm going to do a time lapse of just stitching this.
It's all cold down along the beach. The wind's whipping down the boardwalk. Hey, man!
Hey, man!
You guys know what time of year it is? What time?
What?
Oh, Christmas time. You guys all been good and practicing real hard. Yeah. Clarence, you've been rehearsing real hard now. So Santa, bring your new saxophone, right? Everybody out there been good, or what? Oh, that's not many. You guys are in trouble out here. Yeah, you better watch out. You better not cry. You better not bow. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Okay, so that was a solid, like, roughly, I don't know, 8 minutes of sewing. It was more like 9, I think. And we've got this. As you can see, there are a few marks from my mat. I realized that I forgot to tell you a few things. One, if your fabric frays like mine does, you might want to hem it. But this is not the actual stocking. Another thing is, we're going to pretend that this mat is my fabric. When you do the pattern, you want to do one like this and the other like this. Because you want to do it good side to good side. For instance, see how on my stocking that we'll actually be using, we have one side that's like this, and one side that's like this. You have to sew it where the two fluffy sides are touching each other, and you're sewing. So this one's facing out, this one's facing in, and then we flip it inside out. So when you flip your stocking inside out, make sure to be careful. I've seam ripped, the seams on my own stuff many, many times before. So, something I find works is if I use a pencil sometimes. I'm using the eraser end because I don't want to poke at my stitches too much. So, yeah. I probably would make mine a bit larger next time, but like I said, thankfully this is not the stocking we have to deal with. It's just like a demonstration stocking. But once you've actually made or bought your stocking, one moment please, have to reflip my stocking. Okay, there we go. we're going to be working with this side today. And that's just how it's going to go. So, I'm going to use this for almost like practice decorations, and I have a separate plan for this. So, something you can use sequins, sequins, beads, you could, I don't know, can you write stuff? Maybe you could write stuff, I don't know, you could write something out in hot glue or stitch it on. You could, there's a bunch of different things you can do. So I'm going to do just a few random fun things for this stocking that are not even close to my plan for the proper stockings, but is just meant for demonstration. Okay, so I'm going to use some sequins for this one. If you don't have sequins at home, that's okay. You can get them at places like Dollarama and the Dollar Tree for a couple of bucks. So I'm also going to grab some... One moment, please. Some thin thread. This is more sewing thread, but it's thin, which is what we want. And you're going to cut something that's a certain length. I haven't decided how long I want mine to be, so I'm just giving myself some slack, I guess. And I'm tying it a lot, I think. So I'm going to tie the ends up. I'll tie the ends up, and then what I would do is pick some sequins and just kind of start stringing them on like so until you'll get kind of a long thing. So we're going to do that. I'm going to make the one for this and my additional plan for the stockings. So let's do that now.
Okay, so these are pretty much dry, and yeah, I used hot glue and now there are webs everywhere, so that's fun. So now what I would probably do is, I don't know, glue them to the front. On mine we have like this kind of loose piece. Another thing is I could attach, like tie them to the hangy piece. Ooh, that actually looks very cute. Okay, so now for what we're actually doing for our stockings is my mom has a Cricut machine. So she has kindly cut out a C and an S, hence Cookie and Snowball. And I need to cut out a piece of fabric, which we will attach that piece to, and then either sew it or glue it onto the fluffy area here. So I'm going to grab the fabric and cut it into squares. And then my mom should be ready soon with the heat thing. With the help of my mom, we've got an S and a C on a black thing, on a black piece of fabric. So now we're going to attach it here. Now there are two ways. You can either sew it, or for me, I'm just going to use a little bit of glue and attach that. I'm going to use very limited amounts of glue so that it's not super duper stiff. Camera is kind of in the way. So I'm going to do this off camera because the camera is just very much in the way. Okay, so they are glued on and man do they look cute. Now I'm going to attach my little pretties, shinies, my little things. So I need to choose who's getting what. We're gonna do it like this, I think. I don't know. Okay, so pretty much we lightly kind of roll up. You know, we're hiding that, I don't know, see? We're hiding our problems, I think. There we go. It looks like we're hiding problems, I don't know. You tell me, are we hiding our problems? Okay, so now we are going to very carefully be kind of our attaching, and there we go, it's cute and attached. I'm going to repeat it for Snowball stocking. Okay, so now it's time to go hang these up in the pig's cage and show them the thing and see what they like and yeah. Let's head upstairs.
Okay, so the stockings are done. We got an S for cookie, or no, an S for snowball and a C for cookie. Cookie, you just, you good? Cookie, what do you think? She looks like she's terrified. What do you think? Good? What do you guys think? Okay, so originally I planned to hang them on this side because, well, it used to be over there. But now, I think I'm going to hang them on the shelf because now if they fall, now it's not like close to the cage where they can eat them. So I'm going to quickly hang those up. I'll be right back.
And there we have it, the stockings hung by the chimney with care. Actually, the stockings are more hung by the guinea pig cage with care, but we do have a heater on the floor. Does that count for anything? Okay, so I will see you guys on Friday, which is Christmas Eve. So I will see you guys then. Have a great couple of days until then, and I will see you on Christmas Eve. Bye! This does not feel right. Okay, now, bye.